Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on linear algebra. In the last video we talked about what is a range and null space of a linear transformation, and we also talked about rank and nullity of a linear transformation. In this video we are going to talk about the examples of range and null space of a linear transformation. So for just for the completeness, I'll just quickly write the definition for null space. Null space for a linear transformation is all those vectors in U. Suppose your linear transformation is from U to V, then null space is defined as all those vectors in U whose linear transformation is zero vector in V. And range space of T is defined as all the images of under T. All like what you'll do, you'll take all the elements of U, and then you will take whatever this element is taken to an element of V by the transformation T. So this is null space of T, and this is range of T. The dimension for range of T is called rank, and the dimension for null space of T is called nullity. So in this video we are going to talk about some of the examples. So I'm taking this first example, because if you just look at the definitions, then the things are not very clear. So it is always a good thing that you practice lots of examples. Right, define. So we have a linear transformation T from V3 to V3 defined by T of x1, x2, x3 is equal to x1, x2, 0. So this is the situation that you have a vector space V3 here, another vector space V3 here, and you have a transformation T here, right? And we are looking for a null space here, and we are looking for a range space here. I told you that null space is a subset of the domain, and range space is a subset of the range range means this right hand side vector space. Fine. Okay, so let us find out nt for this particular transformation. So by definition, nt is all those u in v3 which is such that T of U is 0. So you're looking for all those x1, x2, x3 such that T of x1, x2, x3 is 0. 0 means this 0 vector. So here, now the transformation is defined as, you see the transformation is, it is taking x1 to x1, x2 to x2 and x3 to 0. So your transformation is x1, x2, 0. So this quantity here is equal to this. So this is equal to 0, 0, 0. So you get all those x1, x2, x3 such that x1 is 0 and x2 is 0. x3, there is no restriction. So your null space looks like 0, 0, x3, where x3 can be any real number. So your null space looks like this. Right? It means that all the elements, for example, if you take 0, 0, 1 or 0, 0, 2 or 0, 0, 0.3 and so on, all these elements will be mapped to 0, 0, 0. Right? So you can note here, nt here is so many elements. It is not a single element. Nt is a space like this. This you can write this space as alpha into 0 comma 0 comma 1, right? Because you can call just it alpha. So this is this space. So this is a space generated by this element 0 0 1. So this is a span of this 0 0 1. So nt here is a space, this. So dimension of nt is 1, right? Fine. So it means that nullity for this linear transformation is 1. Fine. Also note that because so many elements are mapped to a single element, so T is not 1, 1. You know what is a 1, 1 map? 1, 1 map is that you cannot have like this, that two elements are mapping to the same element, two or more elements. 1, 1 means one element will be mapped only to one element. So here T is not 1, 1 because we can clearly see that all these elements are mapped to 0, 0, 0. Fine. Okay. So we found out the nullity is 1, we found that nt is a space generated by this element 0, 0, 1, and we found out that t is not 1, 1. I'll relate it later on to nt, we'll put a theorem. Right now we are just making observations. Now let us see rt here. Rt is range space of t. So range space of T is defined as TU for all U belongs to U. So this is equal to T of x1, x2, x3 for all x1, x2, x3 belonging to V3. So this is x1, x2, 0, where x1, x2 are real numbers. So you can see that this, what is this, is x1 into 1 comma 0 comma 0 plus x2 into 0 comma 1 comma 0, where x1, x2 are real. So what is this? This is span of 1 comma 0 comma 0, 0 comma 1 comma 0. Right, fine. So this is, and these are linearly independent also. So dimension of, so this is your RT. RT is this, and dimension of RT is the number of elements in the basis. So this is one of the basis equal to 2. Right. And also you note that, so now the things to be noted, note that we found RT is a space generated by 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Right. Okay. And dimension of RT, which we are calling as rank, is 2, number of elements in the basis. This is the note. And one thing more to note, that here you have, this is your range. You see what is happening. You have a transformation from V3 to V3. This range contains all elements of the form x1, x2, 0. So it means that if I have an element here 1, 2, 3 whose last element is non-zero, it does not have a pre-image. Right? Because no element will be mapped to 1, 2, 3. Because every element, the image here is having the third component 0. So all those elements which are infinite in number, where the third component is not 0, they are not having a pre-image. It means that your map looks like this. There is a set here, like you have a transformation. So this set has no pre-image. This is the definition of not onto. So T is not onto. So you just observe this thing, right? Later on you will see what I am trying to say. We'll connect that, what is the relation between onto, being onto, and the rank, right? And the last observation point here you have to note, T is from V3 to V3. So this is your domain space. What is the dimension of domain space? 3. Right? And here also we found rank is 2 and nullity is 1. So 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So just note that in this case, rank plus nullity is equal to dimension of domain space. We'll prove that this is actually a theorem. This is in general true. We'll prove it later on. In this video, we are just looking at examples. So I'm just making all the observations. Okay, now let us do one more example. So you have T from V3 to V2. Fine. T of X1, X2, X3 is equal to x1 minus x2, x1 plus x3, right? So things are same, that you have to observe everything, what is happening. Now you see, you are going from R3, that is V3, here elements are of the form x1, x2, x3, to R2, where elements are of the form x1, x2, and here is your T. This is how you are taking your elements. Now let us find Nt is here. And RT is here. So let us find NT. NT is all those elements in R3 which are mapped to 0. Right. So you are looking for all those elements x1, x2, x3 such that T of x1, x2, x3 is 0. This 0 is for the B vector, right hand side vector. Here right hand side vector is R2. So 0 looks like this. So this is by definition x1 minus x2. So you are looking for x1, x2, x3 such that T of x1, x2, x3 is 0. T of x1, x2, x3 is defined as x1 minus x2, x1 plus x3. This is equal to 0, 0. So this means, this implies x1 minus x2 is 0 and x1 plus x3 is 0. So from here you get that x2 is equal to x1, here x3 is equal to minus x1. So your null space T looks like x1 is x1, x2 is also x1, x3 is minus x1, where x1 is a real number. Fine. Now this you can write it as x1 into 1 comma 1 comma minus 1, where x1 is real. So it means that this is equal to span of this set 1 comma 1 comma minus 1. Right. So this is your NT. This is the required answer for NT. Now you look at the dimension of NT. Dimension of NT is 1, number of elements in the basis. So this is your nullity. And also you see here all these elements. There are so many elements. You take x1 is equal to 1. So 1 comma 1 comma minus 1. It is mapped to 0, 0. If you take 2 comma 2 comma minus 2. It is also mapped to 0, 0. You take 3 comma 3 comma minus 3. It is mapped to 0, 0. So this is not a 1, 1 map. This is not a 1, 1 map. So let me tell you what exactly we will be doing. We'll see that, we'll prove that a map is 1, 1 if and only if null space is having only 0 vector. Okay, this we will prove. We will prove later on. Here we are just making the observation. Here we are just making this observation. Here we are just making this observation. What observation? That this thing is true. Here you see your NT contains so many elements. It is not a set containing only 0 vector. So your map is also not 1, 1. Right? Okay. Now let us talk about range. RT is TU. U belongs to U. U here is V3. So this is T of X1, X2, X3. Where X1, X2, X3 are real. So this is equal to x1 minus x2, and then you have x1 plus x3, right? X1 minus x2, x1 plus x3, where x1, x2, x3 are real. Now we want to see what is this. I claim that this is equal to whole space V2. How? I claim that this is equal to whole space V2. Because given any a comma b, I can write a comma b as x1 minus x2, x1 plus x3. How? What I can do, if I want to make these two equal, so x1 minus x2 is a, x1 plus x3 is b, right? From here, you can see that you get your x2 as x1 minus a, and x3 as b minus x1. So your element x1, x2, x3 looks as this. X1 as such, x2 is x1 minus a, x3 is b minus x1. So for any a comma b, I will choose an element of the form x1 comma x1 minus a b minus x1, where x1 can be any real number and t of this particular element is equal to a comma b. So it means that every a comma b is having a pre-image, right? So this is equal to whole space R2. Is that thing clear? Because for every element in R2, you have a pre-image. Right? So here, this is equal to R2. Range is whole space R2. Right? So dimension of range will be 2. And because range is equal to whole of the right-hand side, therefore, map is on 2. So we will see that linear map T is on 2 if and only if RT is equal to right hand side vector space. And here again you observe that so this is your rank. So nullity plus rank is equal to, nullity here was 1, rank here is 2, is 3, and t is from V3 to V2. So, dimension of domain space. So, this is rank nullity theorem, which we will prove later on. Here we are just making the observation. So, you can do one or two more examples. There are so many examples. You can practice as many as you want. Let me take a very simple map. Let me take zero map. So, you have a map U to U, right? U is same, Z, which takes every element U to a zero vector. Which takes every element U to a zero vector, right? So, it means that all the elements here are mapped to 0. Now, here you can easily guess, because everything is mapped to 0. Therefore, null space is all the U. Because everything in U is mapped to 0. And null space is collecting all those elements which are mapped to 0. Right? And here, because domain range is containing only 0. Range is containing only 0 vector, because everything is mapped to 0. So, here dimension of NT is dimension of U, whatever it is, and dimension of RT is 0. We define the dimension of this vector space, 0. This is a trivial vector subspace, is 0. Right? So, this is your nullity. This is rank. So, you can see that rank plus nullity is your dimension of U, which is the rank nullity theorem. Also here, because everything is mapped to 0, 0, and T is U, therefore it is not 1, 1, and also not on 2. Fine. Now you can take one more example. You take identity matrix, identity map. You take T from U to U, which takes U to itself. Right, it takes U to itself. Now, can you tell me what is nullity here? Nullity is all those U such that T U is 0. So, you are looking for U such that U is equal to 0. So, null space here is 0. 0 vector only. 0, it contains only the 0 vector. So, dimension of null space is 0. Fine? Okay, and map, is it 1, 1? Yes. You can see if T of U1 is equal to T of U2, it implies U1 is equal to U2. So, map is 1, 1. Map is 1, 1. So, you can see that I told you map will be 1, 1 if and only if null space is 0. So, this is true here. Observe that thing. And range here, what will be range? Range is all TU. U belongs to U. So, TU is U. So, this is U. U belongs to U. So, this is U. So, range here is U. Right? So, dimension of range will be dimension of U. So, you can see that this plus this will give you the rank nullity theorem. And also, here map is onto. Why? Because you have something like this. Here is your U, here is your U. Elements are mapped like this. So, every element is mapped to itself. So, obviously, all the elements will be mapped. Right? So, this is onto. And we can see that this is onto. And here range is equal to the right-hand side vector space. This is what I was telling you. Right. So, there are more examples. I can take you one more example. You can take this reflection. So, you have a map from R2 to R2, which is defined as T of x1 comma x2 is equal to x1 comma minus x2. Now, here if you talk about nullity is all those elements which are mapped to 0, 0. So, here this is x1 comma minus x2 equal to 0, 0. So, you get x1, 0, x2, 0. So, you get null space is containing only 0, 0. Right? Okay? And this map is 1, 1. You can see if T of U is equal to T of V, U2, U1 equal to U2, U1 is say X1 comma Y1, X1 comma X2, and this is say, so let us see, this implies T of U1 you call as X1 comma Y1, U2 to call as X2 comma Y2, so this implies X1 comma minus Y1 equal to X2 comma minus Y2, this implies X1 is equal to X2, Y1 is equal to Y2. This implies u1 is equal to u2. So map is 1, 1. This is the definition of 1, 1, right? So whenever you have t of u1 is equal to t of u2, you should get u1 equal to u2. If this happens, then your map is 1, 1. And here you observe that nt is 0. So I told you that we'll prove that map is 1, 1 if nt is 0, right? And you note the dimension of nt, which is your nullity. This is 0, right? And if you talk about range here, range is all the images where x1, x2, they are real, right? So this is equal to x1 comma minus x2, where x1 and x2 are real. So this is whole space R2, right? So you get range is whole space R2 and dimension of range is 2. So your rank plus nullity is 2, which is the dimension of the domain space, right? And also this map is on 2. Right. So there are examples like this. You can practice more examples. So here in this video, we talked about many examples of linear transformations. And I would like to tell you that we have a site called Maths for All. Right. The link is given in the description of this video. Please visit that site. On that site, if you are preparing for some specific exam, for example, if you are preparing for JAM or you are preparing for CSIR, UGC NET, or you are all these are Indian exams, right, for mathematics. If you are preparing for IAS with mathematics as one of the subjects, or you are preparing for GATE, here you will get separate videos for everything, and this is completely free, no charges at all. And also we have a section called quiz. In that section, we are preparing quizzes for you. You can, you know, just, for example, these days we are preparing quizzes for linear algebra. So you can just do this course, linear algebra, and then you can go to that site and you can practice your, you can see your progress, that how much you are progressing in this particular course. And most of these questions, they are based on the questions which were previously in these exam papers, right? And also do subscribe to this channel for latest videos and more information about mathematics. And I also want to tell that so many students or some people, they are asking me to make videos on different subjects, for example, real analysis, numerical analysis, and so on. So I want to tell you guys that there are already these videos, there are so many videos which are on these subjects. You can just look at the playlists. Although these are not exhaustive videos, I'm still making more videos for each subject, right? But still there are so many videos, and you can just check the playlist on this channel, Maths for All, for all what I have made, right? I thank you all for your support and for nice feedback. Thank you so much.